Caught in the macrame web she spun by internal decadence leaves her to live her life on broken wings. The totality of carcasses strewn at her feet comes from sagacious deceptions, filling reels of pictorial film, awaiting its panoramic debut. Dilapidated wrought iron gates slump in neglect as empty ropes swing from the gallows. Trees bend to the way of sorrowful winds convoluting in permanency. Effluvium impregnates the air as the excrements released from the bowels of ghouls and jackals leaves her in a high vegetative state like the ash residue she snorts from crematoriums. Encompassed and guised in monk's cloth is the semblance motif she's ensconced in, retreating into self-imposed exile, corralling for pity, living her life on broken wings. Forlorn by choice parochialism, hoping to conceal the rancor imploding vehemently inside her belly. Incrustations of coil scales coat her tongue. Regurgitated acidic lace breath restricts her speech, adhering to consents. Lines of demarcations leads to extricating atonement from all that knew and loved her. But as Christ approached her fortress, her induced aversion toward his merciful beauty inflamed anger and purulent matter, stirring scabies beneath. Descending from her monstrous sight, he leaves her to the underworld. As she smells her lover nearing, she becomes physically inanimate. Gargantuan in stature, he stands before her. Showing her last covetousness, passions arise, and he gives her the gift she seeks. Dislodged from this life like the arrows released from the bows of an archer's hands, ballerina's swan dance in singed tutus. Expedience asphyxiated voyage into perdition. This her resolve, as she lived her life on broken wings. I let snakes in my house. Snakes that filter and frolic through landscapes of illustrious felt-filled fields between my thighs, somewhere between sorrow and want, releasing their carnal thoughts. Open mouth swallowing salty cream treats, bottom propped on pillows for visual intoxication. Voices, octave above octave. Nails rip at sweaty skin. Cobra's fangs pierce deep beneath my desires. The pinnacle of excitement causes me to yield forward, gusting and gushing like a forceful wind that is fleeting. God calls my name, but snakes defy lusty landfills. I am the nothingness of the day. He weeps and I feel the sting of his tears on my forehead like holy water scarring vampires. I let snakes in my house. Rattlesnakes that captivate, hypnotize, connive, and deceive, searching for a host's womb to hold venomous replication. Pythons wrap around my body whole, squeezing the life out of me. Extended jaws swallow me whole, like tasty rodents running from hot sands caught between their paws. But wise is the owl that sits high above limbs of trees, watching my demise with great delight. Dreary is the sight from this window, as Aurora exalts her beautiful face, beckoning darkness beneath the rim of her skirt. Night, the mothership of all secrets, concubine and bedfellow am I, inheriting the phallic odor of strangers as anarchy combats my senses. Mythical picturesque, disillusioned dreams of America, my back on which you mounted, stroking me with judicial, melodramatic balladry of hypocrisy. In God we trust, in greed we seek. 20th century modern day slavery, a country whose greatest landmarks, monuments, and businesses were crafted by the bludgeoned hands of minorities. Now we turn on our televisions only to hear exquisite babble of debauched commentary and flagrant speeches from our most powerful political figures. Reneged promises and shattered dreams, I trusted you. With unwavering stare, you placed one hand on the Bible and the other in the air and took an oath to uphold the laws of God and land, seducing us to believe in the land of opportunity, where all men are created equal. Galvanized by what you stood for, my quest began when I abandoned my birthplace, who treated me like a whore and tossed me out into the night after being used for its pleasures. Some of us were yanked into this country forcefully, others willingly. Many stowed away in the backs of trucks, ships swam across vast oceans as others died inside cod trunks. I ran to you, only to find out I am still an unwanted whore. Funny what one will do when freedom is supposed to ring. Patriotic songs, white picket fences, land of the free, home of the brave. Take me out to the ball game, peanuts and popcorn. Oh, say, can you see? All bullshit of what the American dream is supposed to represent. But you continue to sodomize us by sadists who reap wealth and power. Come election season, you again have the audacity to ask me to eat from the same spoon of deception, wanting me to lie on my back and spread my legs as you fill my void with liquid prose and poetry, hoping that the euphoric state of seduction will recede my eyes to the back of my head, releasing a climactic scream of ecstasy to see iridescent colors of rainbows painted on raw canvases. Here's the problem, my love. Even a whore knows when to get out of the game. We're not typographical errors that you can conveniently obliterate and delete from history's text. We are willing to work for that from which you stole in order to build your great nation, albeit for me to notice the nefarious narcissist jargon spewed. Ghostly sounds of bells ringing from merchant ships selling live cargo still haunt the bay. Segregated cruelty of a nation's rapture rock the universe. Darkened shades of red, white, and blue are continually revealing injustices and oppressions. It's all here to scourge the throats of those who spat on our civil liberties. From this chalice you will drink the antidote of truth. We are the products of your fortunes, industries, and infrastructures. Your sketchy foundations are cracking the walls of your magnificent towers. You can eradicate this problem by not asking us to leave, but band together to build a broken nation by crying redemption for all races. Allow freedom to ring. Allow freedom to ring.